God. Palakpakan mo natin ang Panginoon. Okay, so pagpapakan mo sa buhay ng mga praise and worship team. Napakaganda po ang pag-awitan at pagdam po natin ang presensya ng Panginoon. Have a blessed. Good afternoon. Mga kapatid, it's always a pleasure to serve God and thank God for this opportunity to serve Him, to deliver His word today. Our faith for this month is in line with the pastor's direction. It is about a new beginning. So our title of the message title for today is about God wants a new beginning. Welcome, mga bakasyonista, chairman and family, Helen. Sino ba mga sa bakasyon? Sir Helen, at si Mother Noel. Welcome back, Brother Randy also, and the visitors, welcome back. Welcome back to the Evangelical Christian Church. There was a story of a couple who want to have a pet in their house. And because they don't have a kid, so they decided to have a pet in their house. And so they decided to buy a cat, a beautiful cat. So when they bought it, they brought it to the house. And then suddenly, they observed that the cat was not behaving properly. The cat is so wild. The cat always throw out the things inside and make poo-poo everywhere. So after 1 month, they lost their patience. So they decided to throw the cat away. So they put the sack, they put the cat in the sack and throw somewhere. After 1 hour, the cat came back. So the wife said, "You just throw it so close. So this time, throw it far away, maybe in the next barangay or the next city, so that the cat came back." So they threw it a little bit farther. Then after one hour, the cat came back. So the wife said, "It's still close." Confused the cat, put in the sack and loop it around the city many times, and then go to the farthest forest and throw it there. After 3 hours, the wife was worried, and he called his husband and said, "Where are you?" And the husband said, "Did you see the cat?" "Yeah, after 3 hours, the cat is here." "And where are you?" "I think I'm the one who is lost." So minsan po sa ating pagmamanipula, minsan sa ating pagplano, we are, you know, we are taking the dose of our own plans. So our message for today is about God wants a new beginning. God wants a new beginning. It was taken from the book of Isaiah chapter 43 verse 18 to 19. So I request to everyone to all rise. And we'll read all together. Ready? "Forget the former things, dwell on the past. See, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Not perceiving, I am making a way in the desert, streams of wisdom." Makaupo na po tayo. Let us have a moment of silence to think of our, you know, of what happened in our lives for the past year, in the 2014. And we will talk to God privately. And we'll have a short prayer, a moment of silence, thinking on the things that God has done last year, and the things that we failed for God. Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful afternoon, Panginoon, that you prepared for us a new message that will touch us, O God. That will touch what we have done in the past, especially in 2014, O God. We made so many decisions, poor decisions, O God, that failed our spiritual life. Lord, teach us how to forget the former things. teach us, O God, how to not to dwell in the past. And teach us, O God, how to make new things in our lives. Father God, I commit to you the message this afternoon. Take over in this congregation, O God. I fully acknowledge, O God, that apart from you, I cannot say anything. If there are any forces of evil that will try to disrupt our focus, our attention, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke. I throw away, O God. I throw away this room. So that ang iyong mga anak, Panginoon, ay manaya, makarinig ang iyong salita. Holy Spirit, come. We dwell with each of you. Bless this room. Bless each of you. Father God, speak to us. Speak to us boldly in your majesty and power. This we ask. In Jesus' name. Amen. na po. Wala po ba kayo napansin sa 2014? Marami po tayong mga bagay na naging victorious tayo, and there are so many things also that we fail in our work, our life, our families, and also our ministries. We fail many times in our service to God. Our message for today is to seek a new vision for 2015 and a new interest in the things of God. The passage from this book of Isaiah was written to the children of Israel, and it came at a bleak period of their history. Ang pag-deliver po ng mensaheng ito ay in the times when the Israelites were held captive from the Babylonians. So the Israelites think that in the past they were slaves in Egypt, and God delivered them from Egypt. So they are thinking the same way that, you know, God will deliver them from slavery. This time, God has prepared another thing. They are in captivity and they lost everything they thought they could keep forever. And now they are homesick to their homeland. They remember how God delivered them from the many trials in the past. And they are still stuck in the hope of God that God will do the same. Same with the Israelites, mga kapatid, we are also held captive to our sins. We are held captive to our principles, our traditions that hinder our growth. This time, it's 2015, we are challenged. We are facing a new challenge by this cruel world. Pasama na po na pasama ang ating mundo. Wala po kayo napapansin sa balita sa ABS or sa GMA. Mas marami po ang masamang balita kaysa mabuti. Ang Ten Commandments po, lahat ng Ten Commandments nandun po sa balita everyday. Do not commit adultery, do not murder. Kung ano yung mga do not, yun po ang ginagawa ng tao. Kabaliktad po sa commands of our Lord. So this time, based on our reference verse today, we can embrace the new beginning. I will translate also ang ating verse sa Tagalog. Huwag ninyong alalahanin ang mga dating bagay, ubulayin man ang mga bagay na nakaraan. Narito ako, gagawa ng bagong bagay ngayon, di ako lalabas. Hindi ba ninyo malalaman yaon? Gagawin ako ng mga daan sa lupang masukal at mga ilog sa ilang. So napakaganda po ng promise ng Panginoon. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 18 to 19. If you are going to move to a new things in Christ, you must learn these things. The first step to embrace a new beginning that God wants us to do is change your focus. Change your focus. From verse 18, sabi po sa verse 18 ng ating text, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. Hindi naman lahat ng kalimutan, ano? Ibig sabihin, the context of this message is to forget the things that are not good, that we fail miserably, the things that are sad memories. So this time we have to change our focus. Quit looking behind and start looking ahead. Alam po natin mga champions of Israel, they have so many victories in the past. You know, when they were slaves in Egypt, the Lord divided the sea para dumaan sila. At nung nakaraan sila, millions of Israelites passed through the sea. At nung dumaan mga chariots and the armies of Egypt, bumalik po ang tubig at sila po ay nanulog at namatay. So the first recorded tsunami was recorded in Egypt. Nung namatay po ang mga Egyptians, ano? So God brought out them from Egypt. God kept them in the desert. For 40 years, the Israelites was wandering in the desert. Wala po silang direksyon. Niligaw po sila ng Panginoon dahil sa kanilang mga kalikuan. But God provided the food in the form of manna. God provided them the shelter by the clouds to cover them the heat. They also have victories when they conquer Canaan, and they survive also when the Israel was divided into two. They have so many victories. They have conquered many places through the help of the hands of God. But now, nawala lahat. They are in captivity by the Babylonians. All their previous victories were done doing nothing to set them free. They needed a new work, a new miracle, and a new victory. Minsan po tayo mga OFW, nakapag-abunan tayo para nagbago ang ating pananaw. Para matingin natin sa mga tao sa Pilipinas ay mababa na. Hindi po ba? Parang ang pahiram na natin, victorious na tayo. Kasi hindi lahat nakapag-abro, di ba? Minsan napromote na ng konti, sa trabaho, pakiramdam na natin mataas na tayo. We have some, you know, victories that we tend to overwhelm, magnify ourselves. Hindi natin alam kung saan nanggaling ang mga victory na pinibigay sa atin, na nanggaling sa na naranasan natin. So, we should control ourselves when it comes to the former things. The former things is not just only the bad things. We have some victory in our past, but sometimes we are not able to control. So sabi ng Panginoon, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. The second, do not depend upon the past victories that sustain you. Forget the former things. Hindi tayo mag-rely sa mga bagay na nakamit natin. Kahit pa nanalo tayo ng mga maraming panalo sa buhay. We won a good job, we won victories from our battles and out in life, but still, we should not depend upon our past victories to sustain us. Yung iba po, pag nakakamit lang ng mga konting karangyaan at bago na pong pananaw, gusto nilang tumigil sa ganong sitwasyon. But, mga kapatid, God has a better plans for us. Way superior than what we have done in 2014 or in the past. Secondly, in order to move into the new things, in Christ, you must know that you must not allow your past failures to possess you. This is commonly happening in our lives. Pagka po tayo na-depressed, pagka tayo po na-fail, nagmumungkala sa bahay, ayaw natin lumalaw. Pag hindi tayo na-ako na magandang trabaho, ayaw natin mag-apply. We always tend to stop. So do not allow your past failures to possess you. Minsan po, may mga relationship failures, family failures. And sometimes, yung iba po, umibigay na, magpapakamatay na lang. Hindi na kinaya. So, the Lord Jesus Christ, even in our captivity, teaches us that you should not allow your past failures to possess you. Hindi tayo pwedeng tumigil na lang sa ganong sitwasyon. Na kahit marami tayong mga pagsubok, marami tayong mga bagay na hindi na kaya, we should move on. We should not be held captive by our past failures. God was not condemning the Israelites, even for their past rebellious actions in the past. Same as, marami tayong mga bagay na hindi nalulugod ng Panginoon. No matter how we try, we still pray in God. No matter how we strive for more spiritual activities, we fail. We could not do nothing. We cannot change the past. Instead, God, kahit nag-fail tayo sa Panginoon, God is holding out His hand to give us hope. He is in effect saying that, forget your past. I'm giving you an opportunity to start over and over again this coming year. And we should start this coming year of 2015. Sabi mo sa Isaiah chapter 55, sabi po sa 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. So, dapat ganun po tayo. Laging bago. Kung mayroong failure, just go on. Just proceed with our life. Life will not stop from our simple mistake or even a bigger mistake. We have to continue because binago na tayo ng Panginoon. We are a new creation. Meron po akong isang kasama sa praise and worship dati. Ako yung nagugulat sa kanyang paglilingkod sa Panginoon. Every day, naglilingkod siya sa Panginoon. He play music every day. Dahil po aming prayer meeting sa Saudi Arabia is meron din pong practice ng praise and worship. So, Saturday to Wednesday, nandun siya sa church. Ang kanyang pahinga is Thursday lang. And sometimes Thursday, he will gather all the kids. Pupunin na sila Hana, nung maliit pa sila Darian, and he will teach musical instrument and voicing. Lahat. Meron siyang trabaho, but still, he want to spend his life serving the Lord. One day, I asked him, bakit ganun na lang ang iyong paglilingkod sa Panginoon? Parang minsan papabayaan ang iyong pamilya, yung trabaho niya, minsan managang na-compromise. Ang sabi niya sa akin, kapatid, gusto mo humawi sa Panginoon. Dahil nung college pa ako, hindi pa ako Kristiyano, I was involved in a fraternity hazing. Isa siya sa mga tagabalok ng mga Nilephites. At isa sa pinakasikat na fraternity sa Pilipinas, one day, sa kanilang hazing, napatay nila yung Nilephite. At ganun na lamang ang kanyang konsensya at umiwalag siya sa fraternity nung namatay ang kanilang Nilephite. So, dala-dala niya hanggang nasa nagiging Kristiyano na siya, dala-dala niya yung konsensya na baka ako na yung palo kung nakapatay ko sa Nilephite na yun. Hindi siya na nakausan. Hanggang siya naglingkod siya sa Panginoon, gusto niya bumawi, lahat na lang gagawin niya para sa Panginoon. Hindi na siya nakausan. Dala-dala niya ang konsensya na at one point in his time, some 10 years or 20 years back, nakapatay siya ng tao. Sabi niya sa akin, hindi ko maalis. Sabi ko, kapatid, bago lang Kristiyano, pero alam ko, when we accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, sabi nga dito sa ating verse, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 10, we are a new creation. All our previous sins were already cleansed by the blood of Jesus Christ. We are a new creation. Kahit anuman, kahit gaano kasama, gaano kalaki, gaano kaliit ang ating kasalanan, we are a new creation. Everything was done and a new has come. So that time he realized that why should the past keep on hunting me when I can serve God freely na hindi yung conditional. We should not serve God conditionally. Na I want to serve the ministry, I want to sing kasi dati wala akong boses, so now he gave me a good voice. Every one of us is a gift. It's a matter of discovering our gift in order to serve God. Sabi mo sa Isaiah chapter 55, verse 7, let the wicked forsake his way and the evil man his thoughts. Let him turn to God and he will have mercy on him. And our God, for he will be freely pardoned. Lahat, you should abandon all our past memories. na hindi nakapagbigay sa atin ng kabutihan. Hindi naman nakapabuti. Why we should dwell in the past? Amen? We should move forward to what God has prepared for us. We made a lot of poor choices in the past, and if we don't forsake it, we cannot have mercy. Mercy will not abound to those who dwell in his past. Pardon will not be given to us. Alam po natin mga, alam niyo mga kapatid, sin starts by a single act. Sometimes, the work of the enemy is what starts kung saan ating kahinaan. Pagka nakita ng kalaban ng ating kahinaan, doon po siya papasok. Ah, itong kapatid na to, mahilig po sa pagkain. Bibigyan ko tanong doon kung mahilig magluto at mapalayo sa gawain. Itong kapatid na ito, mahilig kong gumalak. Bibigyan ko ito ng mga grupo na mahilig gumalak para mapalayo siya sa gawain. Sin starts with a small action. Parang kung minsan, pag pumunta sa Pilipinas, and we meet our old friends, at napadaan ka doon sa dati mong kaibigan na nag-iinuman, at yaya ka, pare, shot. So kahit na Kristiyano ka, gusto mong pagbibigyan. By a single shot, pinagbigyan mo. Sa kanadaan mo doon, napapasyat ka na napasyat, bago ka umuwi, ano ka na, kumakampay ka na. Di mo ba? Because you know what? Why? Sin starts with a single action. Minsan po sa akin, may magyayag, oh, huwag ka mo nang mag-Friday worship service. Friday, minsan lang naman, sama na pa sa grupo natin, mamasyal tayo, o mag-bandit tayo, mag-jamming tayo. Total, in a year, there are 52 weeks. There are 52 Fridays, ano pa naman yung one Friday, so I still have 51 Fridays that I can attend praise and worship or I can attend the worship service. Minsan, pinagbibigyan natin. Kapag nagbigay ito one time, nasarapan ka, di ba? Then, parang dumalas ang ating pagsasama. And fine, you will find out yourself that you will already lost from the church. You know why? Because sin starts with a single move. Meron po isang kwento ng isang igol. May isang pusa na gusto niya kumain ng ibon. Kaso ang ibon mataas, hindi niya kayang lundahin. It tried to catch a bird, but he cannot catch it. So one day, he collected some worms. So many worms. And nung nakita ng ibon, wow, what a food. So sabi ng pusa, I'll give you one worm. But on conditions that you will give me one feather of your wings. So sabi ng ibon, man, I have so many feathers in my wings. I can give you one, but give me the worm. Nung tinikman ng ibon ang worm, isarapan po ang ibon. So sabi ng God, okay, I will give you more. But give me more feathers of your wings. Hanggang sa naubos po ang worms, at nabusog po ang ibon. Then the bird, okay, fine, thank you for the food, I will go. Sa kanyang paglipad, nakalimutan niya na bawas na pala ang kanyang feathers. And then slowly, the bird fall down. And the bird catches, and the cat catches the bird. Ganun po ang kasalanan pa nga kapatid. Nag-umpisa po sa simpleng akala natin na hindi mali. Sa simpleng akala natin hindi mali. Later, we find ourselves na lumubog na tayo, hindi natin kayo lumipad, just like the bird. Inain ng pusa ang ibon dahil sa balahibong isang nag-umisa. So, we must be careful because the enemy is not sleeping. The enemy is making double time, especially in this 2015. He's working hard to make us astray. Para po tayo maligaw sa gawain dahil, you know, nandun ang ating puso kung lumago. The more we try to na lumago tayo sa Panginoon, ganun din po ang kaaway. So, gagamitin niya ang mga tao, mga bagay, na nandun ang ating kahinaan. The second step to embrace the new beginning is to allow God to make a new thing. Tayo po, normally, ayaw natin pagbabago, di ba? You always tend to feel in a comfort zone and I don't like change. Kasi, nakasanayan ko na to. I don't like to change my lifestyle. I don't like to change my principles. I don't like to change my values. But God, sabi ng Panginoon sa ating text, sabi sa text natin kanina, I have a new thing for you. So, if you are going anywhere in your spiritual life, behold, sabi ng Panginoon sa verse 18, behold, I will, verse 19, behold, I will do a new thing. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 19. Marami po sa atin, mabago pa lang, mabilis po lumago. Nakaka-bless po mga kapatid natin na nandun po ang kailang kapuspusan. Just to serve God, to know God, to look for, to fight for righteousness in life. At marami po sa atin matagal yan. So, yung mga bago pong mananampalatay para mga palaya, na pag tinanim mo, ba, kinabukasan, tinanim mula, musbong, kumalat, at yung nilagay mo sa isang lumang mga sanga, nakikita mo kung paano sila kumalat. One day, in just a few days, you can see a fruit. Namunga na po ang palaya. Ganun din po ang mga bagong mananampalataya. But, marami po sa atin, matagal na, hindi na po namunga. Tumigil na po. Mga kapatid, it's 2015. It's time for us to evaluate ourselves. What God can do for me in 2015, for you and me, for the next coming years? Ano ba ba ang nagagawa, ang magagawa natin sa Panginoon? Do not ask what God has done in the past, because past is past, and you cannot turn the hands of time. You cannot turn back the hands of time and say, God, I will do the mistake that I've done 11 months ago. Kasi, I'm regret ko lang kung change ako. Minsan, gusto natin bubugin natin sarili, sana hindi ko ginawa yun. Sinasampal-sampal natin natin. Sana hindi ko ginawa yun. Kung pala sinampal ko yung partner mo. Di ba? Sana hindi ko ginawa yun. So we cannot turn back the hands of time to correct your mistakes in the past. So what we will do? Allow God to make a new thing for you. Para sa dating ng panahon, hindi ka na makasakit, hindi na tayo makasampal, hindi na tayo magkaroon ng kaaway, hindi na tayo magkaroon ng mga bagay na hindi nakapagbigay ng kalugulan sa ating Panginoon. Behold, I'm doing a new thing. A new personality. Diba? Si Jacob, he changed his personality, he changed his name. He changed from Jacob, the deceiver, into Israel, the Prince of God. Diba? Jesus Christ even changed the name of Saul into Paul. He changed the name of Simon into Peter, means the Rock. Hindi naman kailangan baguhin natin ang mga pangalan, kapatid. Baka next Friday na tayo magkakilala. But, you know, the context of changing our personality is to change na, uy, si kapatid ba yan? Dati kilala ko yan. Grabe, malutong magmura yan. Yung mga wow effect, di ba? Yung mga pagbabago sa ating personality. Nakita niyo po si Manny Pacquiao? Ang personality ng pag-usapan, wala kong katalo kay Manny Pacquiao. He is the greatest boxer of all time. Di ba? But he changes his personality from the greatest boxer of all time to an evangelist. Lahat ng mga tao na kapaligid sa kanya, i-convert to God. Nagbago po ang pananaw. Adik na adik na po si Manny Pacquiao ngayon. Hindi adik sa bisyo, adik na adik sa salita ng Panginoon. Dapat ganun po tayo. Hindi po ba? Kung si Manny Pacquiao na napakayaman, sikat, kaya niyang baguhin ang kanyang personality. How much more? Tayong mga sinin tao lang. Hindi po ba? Kaya baguhin natin ang ating personality if we allow God to change ourselves, if we allow God to make a new thing in our lives. God promises us a life of spontaneous, yung tuloy-tuloy na life. Yung creativity, life of creativity, productivity, and provisions. Move on na tayo mga kapatid. Let us not dwell on the past. Let us move on. Sabi nga ni Pastor Robert, let it go mga kapatid. This is the right time to let it go. this is the right time to let it go. Sabi po sa Genesis chapter 32 verse 28, your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel. Because you have struggled with God and with men, and you have overcome it. Diba? Lahat po tayo, we have struggles in our faith to God. We have so many struggles in our life, in our families, in our friends, in our work. But nakikita po natin ang Panginoon, nakikita ng Diyos ang ating mga struggle. Because you struggle with God, because you struggle with men, and you have overcome, and you change, and you go back to me, I will change your personality also. God wants to transform us by renewing our mind. But sometimes, we want to change others. Sana baguhin na ng church ko ng patakaran dyan. Hindi ako pumakarte. Sana baguhin na ng leadership, ng council, mga patakaran ng church. Sana baguhin na ng amo ko yung trabaho namin. Hindi ako pumakarte. We always see other mistakes. We always evaluate others' circumstances. But we always fail to evaluate also ourselves. Yung i-evaluate natin, tayo ba may pagkukulang? Tayo ba may maling pananaw? We have to change our principles. Not only personality, we have to change also our principles. One of our struggles as Christians is to change our traditions. To change yung mga tradisyon na naman natin sa ating mga ninuno, sa ating mga grandparents, our parents. You know, si Peter, mga kapatid, in one of his prayers, si Peter po, Peter saw in his vision, nakita po niya yung mga four-footed animals sa kanyang vision. He saw reptiles, wild animals, birds in the air. And then a voice in heaven told Peter, "Peter, take one and kill and eat." Ito yung mga bagay na pinapakita kay Peter na bawal sa kanya. Sabi ni Peter, "Surely, Lord, surely, Lord, nothing impure, nothing unclean will ever enter my mouth." Pansin niyo po. Peter is maprinsipyong tao. Siya hindi pwede. Hindi pwede papasok sa aking bibig ang mga pagkain unclean. Mga wild animals, mga ahas, mga baboy ramong. The four-footed na pinagbabawal sa manong unang panahon. Anong sabi ng voice? Anong sabi ng Panginoon? The voice spoke from heaven the second time. Sa Acts chapter 11 verse 9, "Do not call anything impure that God has made clean." Do not make anything impure that God has made clean. Ano mong ibig sabihin, mga kapatid? Forget the former things. Forget your past. Do not dwell on your past principles. Baguhin na natin ating pananaw. We have so many things which is very challenging to change in our lives. Especially our spending habits, our pakikitungo sa mga friends, our pakikitungo sa mga non-Christians. Sometimes we tend to give away all the time, most of the time. At wala tayong parang puro hatak lang tayo, puro bigay lang tayo, wala tayong hatak. Di mo ba? Habang nakihalubilo tayo sa mga non-believers, we always give away na parang ikaw natuloy ang nahahatak papalabas. Di mo ba? So the third step that we have to embrace for a new beginning in this year 2015 is recognize His plans. Recognize God's plans. Sabi po niya sa verse 19, it springs up. Did you not perceive it? Did you not have noticed it? Did you not know it? Hindi niyo ba napapansin? Sabi ng Panginoon sa verse 19, Isaiah 43 verse 19, did you not perceive it? It springs up. I'm doing a new thing. It springs up. Did you not notice it? Mga kapatid, sometimes, maraming ginawa ang Panginoon sa atin na hindi natin napapansin na Diyos pa lang gumawa. Sometimes we claim merit na kasi magaling ako eh. I work hard for it. But you know, God, He pour out His blessings without our knowing sometimes. Hindi natin alam, but you know, we are not, hindi natin iniisip eh. That's why God said, did you not notice it? Did you not know it? That I did things to you without you asking for me. Minsan po, while we are driving to many places, we pray for protection. Lord, protect me, protect my car, protect my families. God answered. He protect our traveling, our pamamasyal, He protect our families, He protect our car, but we become back. Anong ginawa natin? God answered our prayer. He protected us, but we will come back. We never pause. Sometimes we pause, but most of the times we don't pause that, oh God, thank you for your protection. Thank you that you answered my prayer. We always forget the things that God has done for us. Kaya, He remind us today, have you not noticed it? I did something for you. Brothers and sisters, God did something for you, but still you didn't notice it. So He remind us today that when He do something new, we allow God to do something in our lives, it springs up. And we should notice it. We should recognize His plans. Jeremiah, very common verse. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. Ano po sabi? For I know the plans for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Wow. Minsan, lagi natin naninurize, no? I think most of us memorize this verse, but have you ever wondered how this verse affect your life? Does it really affect? Most of the time, we question this verse. Talaga, Lord, you prosper me. You don't harm me. You really have plans to give me hope and a future. Bakit ganito buhay ko? Bakit nga ba? If God plans for a better future and God and a hope, not to harm us, but to prosper us, why we are suffering? Why we question God about what's happening in our lives? In the past year or in the past years. Bakit? Because we stop in verse 11. We should read also verse 12 and 13. 29 Jeremiah verse 12. Ang sabi, then you will call upon me and you will come and you will pray to me. Then I will listen to you. Hello? Amen mo ba?
Amen.
Sabi sa 13, you will seek me and find me. Kailan po? When we seek me with all your heart. Ang tanong, did you seek God with all your heart? Or petik-petik lang? Tama na, makapag-church at every Friday, makapag-Bible study, just to be in the church. Hindi po ganun ang Panginoon. The reason why we will not prosper, the reason why the plans for God will not materialize in our lives, because, you know, we will not call upon His name. We don't come to Him. We don't pray a lot. Pray to me. And He will respond, I will listen to you. When I listen to you, I will prosper you. I will give you hope and a better future. This is the God's plan. When you seek me with all your heart. Diba sabi ng Panginoon, love your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your might, with all your strength. If you don't seek our God with all our heart, then you cannot find Him. Isaiah 59 verse 2, sabi niya, dahil sa ating mga kalikuan, nagiging bingi ang Panginoon. Isaiah 59 verse 2, because of our iniquities, hindi niya pakinggan ang ating mga panalangin. Patuloy tayong gumawa ng kasalanan, patuloy tayong sumuhay sa kanyang mga kautusan, then how can God hear us? How can God listen to us if we don't come to Him, if we don't call upon His name, if we don't pray? He will not listen to us. So, the plans will not prosper. The plans of God will not prosper. To come to Him with all our heart, sabi sa verse 13, when you seek me with all your heart, call me, come to me, pray to me, I will listen to you, I will prosper you. That's how we embrace a new beginning in this year, mga kapatid. Sometimes in our success, we blame ourselves. We done it. I did it. Na-promote ako. Yes, Lord, thank you. But sometimes we blame, sino ba na-promotion? Is it really you? Or God, the strength of God that He gives you, the wisdom of God na binigay sa atin pang tayo mag-isip. The last step that we embrace for the new beginning is claim God's promise deliverance. Merong promise ang Panginoon ng deliverance. Sa verse 19 ng ating text, sabi, God is making a way in the desert and streams in the wasteland. In other verse, I'm going to make a way for you to go through the desert. I will make streams of water in the dry and empty land. In other version, I will make streams of water in the dry and empty land. Parang tayo nandun sa punong-punong ang problema. We are full of trials, problems, puro ganun na lang ang naranasan natin. We are in the middle of nowhere in the desert. Just like in the desert where there is no resources you can take. No water, no trees, no plants. Wala kang may nung wala makain. Ang problema ay parang ganun, nasa kalagitan ka. Ng mundong kawalan. Nasa gitna ka ng mundong kawalan. You are in the middle of the desert. Wala ka ng, hindi mo na alam anong gagawin mo. Di ba? We have to claim God's promise and deliver us, mga kapatid. God promised us a life, a continuous life, a spontaneous life. Sabi nga sa Isaiah chapter 43 verse 26, put me in remembrance and let us argue together. Isaiah chapter 43, tandaan niyo po, napakagandang verse po. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 26, put me in remembrance and let us plead together. Let us argue together. Ipaalala niyo sa akin. You know why? God has so many promises. God, in His wisdom, in His mercies, He has so many promises for us children, lalo na po sa mga disciples. Pero kailan po nagiging disciples? Sabi ng Panginoon, you will be my disciples if you follow my command. Pero kung minamina ka, paano ka matawag ng disciples? Diba? Put me in remembrance. Isaiah chapter 43 verse 26. Remind God of His promises. If you incorporate the promises of God in our prayer, it develops our confidence. And God cannot say no in our prayers. You know why? Because God cannot lie. When He promises, He fulfills. Sabi sa Numbers chapter 23 verse 19, God is not a man that He should lie, nor a son of man that He should change His mind. Does He speak and then not act? Does He promise and not fulfill? Why? Di ba mga kapatid? God cannot lie. When He promises, He will fulfill it. He will not change His mind. He is the same today, yesterday, and tomorrow. God cannot lie, and He will not change His mind. If you incorporate that promises, ang sabi niya, put me in remembrance. In your prayer, put me in remembrance. Paalala niyo sa akin kung ano nagawa niyo, di ba? Sabi niya sa verse 26, put me in remembrance, and we will argue, and we will see what you have done, if it is righteous or not. Diba? Babalansin niya. He will put him in remembrance, but he will balance. He will discuss. He will see your righteousness. Hindi lang basta-basta. Because God is fair. God is fair to His people. Titus chapter 1 verse 2. A faith and knowledge resting on the hope of eternal life, which God, who does not lie, promised before the beginning of time. Remember mga kapatid, ito ang hindi kayang gawin ng Panginoon. He can do all things. He created this world. But He cannot lie because God is not a man. Hindi katulad natin. Kasisimba lang natin paglabas kung sinungaling na tayo. Why? Because we are human. And God is not a man. He's not even poor. He is not a man. He is holy. So He cannot die. What we have learned today, mga kapatid, the message is clear. We have to forget our former things. Kalimutan natin ang nagawa sa 2014. Mga bagay na nasira sa ating mga samahan, sa ating mga kakapatiran, sa ating church, sa ating G-group, sa ating pamilya, sa ating